ud, når skaterne kaster sig op i luften på deres skateboards, og de fleste af dem er ikke ret gamle. Vi har mødt en af skaterne, en ung amerikaner, der er 10-dobbelt verdensmester i freestyle.
Så er der Ubyen, professor af skateboarder fra Santa Cruz. Rodney Mullen, verdens bedste freestyler, han er på besøg i Danmark. Jeg tror, han bor her. Så jeg smutter lige op og ser, om han er der. Hey, Rodney.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, how's it going?
Pretty good.
Welcome to Denmark.
Thanks.
Yeah. So how is it being back here?
It's pretty good. Actually, it's great. Yeah, because I made some friends last time I was here, you know, right. Like to see them. It's such a good feeling.
Mm-hmm. When were you here last time?
About a year ago. I don't know.
So back in doing demos and
then... Yeah, on the road again. Cool. It feels really good because at home I've been doing all these tours, you know, with all these other skaters. Now that I'm here, I feel really relaxed, you know? And the schedule's not too bad this time.
Really?
Last time I was getting really sick. Who is Rodney Mullen? It's getting scary because the more I see it, like I'm more distinct, different people now. Schizophrenic almost. Well, I'm a kid from Florida, and I grew up a little bit in the city, and then I moved to a farm later on. And I was pretty good, but I grew up kind of an angry little guy in a way because I had kind of an intellectual background with my parents, both. Like, my mom was a physicist, and my father's a doctor, and they were both athletes, so I had that, a good upbringing. But then, the South, it bothered me a lot because it's very extreme. So, I guess I was a little quietly rebellious. I was a good boy, you know, everything. So I had that inside me, and I played standard sports and everything to begin with. Baseball I did a lot of, and... a little football and some karate, which I like. But I got involved when I was in this game when I was about 10, and I entered a big contest when I was 13. And I won it, right? That was my big world championship.
Is that when you became professional, or were you already professional there?
I turned pro just when I was 12, and then I won the big contest when I was 13. So it's kind of natural for me skating. Yeah.
What was it like when you turned pro? That's like 10 years ago.
Yeah, it was. I remember, like, I was scared because I'd always been in Florida, and then I came to the West Coast, and with this big company, you know, Powell, and I was thinking, man, I don't even belong because all these guys are cream of the crop. But I did. I felt a lot of weird pressure. Like, I had to perform in the ads, and I'd call up, you know, Stacy and go, I've learned this and that and this and that, and I couldn't even talk to him like a person. It was like he couldn't deal with me either. No, because I was like a little animal. You could skateboard, that's all. Skating's given me a lot. Like, now I can look, you know, facts, what I have. I have some money, and I've done a lot of traveling, and you can say I've been something of a star. And yeah, I guess those are the main things that you can look immediately and say, hey, this guy signed autographs and he's traveled around. What it's given me, it gave me a real outlet too. Like, I was really, really shy to begin with, and scared of people. Like, I was kind of a freak, I guess. And, it gave me a lot of confidence, you know, because I got to go my own way. And so, first it gave me kind of an escape to begin with. And then pretty soon, I started traveling around, and meeting pretty talented people. You know, you meet all walks of life. And what's neater, you're something special all of a sudden, and they'll come to you, and they want to mix. I really realized that I was kind of a star all in one summer. I went skiing, was very small for a while, and I'd been isolated in Florida. And then I went on tour through the U.S., and I realized skating had gotten so big. And I was signing autographs, and kids were coming up to me asking me all these crazy or stupid questions or whatever, you know. And I couldn't handle it. And I'd throw the pin away, and I wouldn't say, you know, I can't sign this because don't you see I'm one of you? And they didn't even understand. They think, oh, this guy's got such a big head, you know, or why is he such a weirdo? And it was hard because all of a sudden you're somebody different. And I watched it happen to my friend all at once, and he shot up to be like a superstar. And you could see him around his old friends. Like, you could see his eyes rolling around because he's, I should act this way, and then I should act this way. And then it turns out now he's actually kind of suicidal. So what it's given me is a lot of extremes. And I'm pretty lucky at this because I think I've got my feet on the ground a little better now. But still, I go through weird phases. Like, whenever I do a big demo, big contest, after all these people come up to me, I get really depressed, like, really down and dark, because it's all so unnatural, and you have to give a lot, but it's so unnatural. I can see why a lot of big guys would turn to drugs or whatever, because, I mean, you really don't feel you fit in. Even my trophies, everything. I saw them all heaped together, and I threw them all away. I started to just crush them, you know, and I threw them all away. Because I was thinking, man, because I look at them, I started getting kind of proud. And I was thinking, yeah, I did something. And I looked at myself a couple of days later, I was going, God, I can't, you know, what if I have a kid? I can't put pressure on him like that. You know, hey, look what your dad did a long time ago. He was something.
Sure, I never thought about that. Yeah.
So I don't have any more trophies.
Is skating a sport or is it a lifestyle?
Not either, you know. I mean, I can't really figure going to the Olympics.
Nah, everywhere you go,
you have seems like in every small little like hobby or sport or whatever it is, you have these real extreme guys, you know, going like, you know, Yo-Yo is gonna go to the Olympics, right? And you have some sort of weird sleigh. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
And people say that about skating, and I can't even bear to listen to them. And
it's never gonna work.
Yeah, how can you? I mean, you're confining something a lot. So it's not that lifestyle. I guess you could say it is, but it is tied with, the subculture, whatever.
Yeah.
But then there are people who hype that because they don't have anything else either. It's just, it's something for yourself. Like, the way I look at it for me, it's been almost like writing, you know? Like, a lot of kind of wise guys you read about, you know, there are biographies, and they say, you know, my writing just came out because I would explode if I didn't do it. And that's how it is for skating for me, you know? Which then you can say, oh, it's art. But it's not.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. I feel the same way, kind of. Even we skate different kind of stuff, but I think it's the same feeling because I just, if I don't skate for a long time or for a few days, it's like there's so much energy inside me that has to go out somehow. And I don't do it by arguing with people or go in a tunnel and start shouting or something. I have to go skateboard then. And if I go skate for a few hours, I just feel so good afterwards. Because the feeling, not only the lifestyle and the fact that you're skateboarding and it's pretty cool, but also the feeling it gives you is so good. It's such a nice feeling. It's like defying gravity kind of thing. And I don't know. It's like riding a wave, I guess.
Therapeutic.
It's a big roller coaster thing inside you that makes you feel good.
Yeah.
That's what I think.
What do you think about when you are skating?
You know, all kinds of things. People think it's all concentrated, right? They read these Zen books and stuff. Which is, you know, it's true, you're one of everything and you blank out things and you have these incredible feelings that you can't really describe. You know, I've heard musicians say a lot of things that I can relate to. Real artsy things, you know, you feel one and you lose a sort of consciousness, but then you feel part of a whole, you know? And I was into kind of this Eastern philosophy for a while, and I can understand that's real. But then other times I just think of my dog and stuff like that, you know? I'm just screwing around. And it's not Rocky. The biggest mistakes I ever made was watching Rocky, you know? I was serious about my training. I did a certain type of rolling tricks for 47 minutes, a certain type of static tricks for, you know, 32 minutes. Took a 3-minute break in between. I ran 3.75 miles after. You know, all these weird, stupid things. Everything was by this and wasn't by this. And all of a sudden I realized that my skating wasn't that good anymore. I was mechanical and that I didn't look forward to doing it anymore. One thing's for sure, the skating thing is something in my life, but I want to make a transition out of it and always skate for myself, but never ever talk about it, you know. And I think I'll end up out of the skateboarding business and go back to school. My dad says I'll be a professor, right? Because can't take the real world, which I can. I'll probably end up getting married too, which is before I was really angry at girls. I hated girls. Because they suck up your life, right? You can't have yourself anymore. And so I figured that was bad. But now I'm mellowing out there. So I'll probably end up getting married and being a professor, maybe a poet, or this eccentric old man that's going to walk around and yell at everyone. Hey, folks, believe in me. Because I'm a disciple. The horrors of the big microwave. The instant dinner for the man in the cave. I'm sure the Lord would forgive your faults. Now you just give me your gold and follow my call. 'Cause I'm one hell of a kid. I'm God's favorite. 'Cause me and the Lord, we got this heavenly deal. He is my master and he told me to steal. Yeah, me and the Lord, we got this 50-50 split. The old man. Just to become a good skateboarder, have fun with it. Like anything, how are you going to get good? Just have fun and stick with it. Don't go halfway and don't use it like a social tool. Like skate to the corner and hang out with your friends and skate back. That's what someone said. And so that's to be a good skater. To be a great skater, something hard. It takes a really weird combination. You have to have kind of natural talents. You know, you can skateboard, you have a certain balance, and you're not too big, not too small. And you have to have kind of a lot inside you, I think.
Dedication.
Oh, yeah, dedication and a sense of discipline and all that. Yeah. But also the creative side or whatever, you have to have it mean something for you. Like, you know, you went through these artists, and they all had a lot bottled up inside. And I think to be someone really great at what they do, you have to have something really showing in your skating that's you.
All the tricks you are doing at the floor, is that some tricks you are creating yourself?
Yeah, actually most of them. Yeah, honestly, that's my strong point. So, of course, I tend over. Like I was thinking today, you mentioned actually one guy that's learning one of my tricks, and this whole skating is kind of modeled after mine, right? Which, like my friends say, hey, take it as a compliment. That's the best form you can get. But inside I get really angry, and he competes against me too, and I think, God, how dare the judges even try to judge him when he's skating next to me, which is right, big ego. But it's true for me, it is, because he's never done anything on his own, and I get kind of down on that. But then I have to mellow out and say, hey, you know, it's okay.
You gotta realize that since you are the best, everybody's looking up to you. Even other professionals are looking up to you, and maybe they don't have the same creative mind as you have, so they don't figure out all these tricks themselves.
Yeah.
Plus, the tricks that you do are really hard and look really good, so obviously people have to do them. It's the same with ramp skating.
Yeah,
I mean, totally. Tony Hawk is really
best
in front of everybody else, and everybody copies his tricks. Just to keep up with him, try to keep up with him, or keep up with the standards of skating.
From where did you get the inspiration to make new tricks?
Yeah. I thought a lot about that too. I think from a lot of stuff bottled up inside me. Yeah, that's how I did it, sort of. I mean, I read about these guys, like, seriously good guys. Beethoven, even. Beethoven was my hero, right? And he was so punk. You know, he'd have a mohawk if he were around today, I think.
Have you ever felt some kind of a conflict between that you are skating in a subculture and then you're in money at it?
Yeah. At first I felt, yeah, some conflict, you know. Because it... When stand up for something kind of extreme, you know, you shouldn't do it and you shouldn't participate. But on the other side, you know, hey, we can use you and the opportunity. So I felt conflicts. But in the end, I figured, look, just go ahead and do it, you know, experience things. And they have a lot to give you. You know, you're not, in a sense, kind of prostituting yourself or anything bad or dirty like that. So yeah, go ahead, you know, enjoy. That's what I'm doing now. And in the end, it's been nothing bad either. I mean, it's been one of the best decisions I made.
You have now chosen the freestyle. Why not the street style or the ramp?
Yeah, I asked myself that too. First, well, to begin with, there was sort of a freestyle or flatland. You get good at that. I was sponsored already. Ramps came out, and I got good at that, and it seemed more fun. It's a neater feeling, you know, you're weightless and all that. And I enjoyed that more, but then my teeth, I knocked them out. My parents didn't want me to do it. And, man, I kind of wish still sometimes I would have gone that route. But when I look inside myself, I'm more of a freestyler. Because to me, there's really nothing better. You can go out in a little area under a streetlight and your whole world, you know. So, yeah, that's why I like street skating is okay, but... At first, I didn't respect those guys at all. I thought they were nothing. You know, they weren't quite doing either one. They were halfway fence sitters.
Jeg startede med at skate for 10-12 år siden nu. Der var Rodney, han var et af mine idoler. Og jeg kan ikke se andet end det, han er altså bare stadig. Helt fantastisk.
Hvad er det, der gør Rodney til så god en skater, som han er?
Jeg tror, det er flere faktorer, der spiller ind. Det er koncentrationsevne, det er viljestyrke. Naturligvis er det også talent. Man skal nok have et talent for at kunne blive så god, som han er. Der er flere ting, der spiller ind, og dem besidder han alle sammen, og derfor er han så god. Det, der er helt utroligt ved, det er, at han stadig er god, synes jeg, fordi han har prøvet alt. Han har været med i toppen i de sidste 10-12 år nu, været professionel. Han har vundet alt, hvad der er at vinde, men stadig så har han den her sejrsvilje. Han nægter at tabe.
Han udskiller sig på den måde, at han går op i nogle andre ting i sin fritid, end nok de fleste af dem af skaterne gør. Det tror jeg, altså, han læser meget filosofi, meget tunge bøger, som er på højt stadie på universitetet. Ikke? Og han kom jo fra en universitetsuddannelse på, altså han har været i gang med 4 år, hvor han så stoppede, fordi han måtte dedikere det hele til skating. Men alt hans fritid går med at læse. Og det er altså, det er nogle bøger, man faktisk ikke kan, man kan læse en side, og så kan det kan tage en time, ikke? Og man kan ikke forstå en skid af det alligevel, ikke? Altså, man skulle ikke umiddelbart tro, at han havde været så meget rundt, som han har været, fordi han har jo både til det ene og det andet interview, og Hollywood der er han med i de diverse film, og laver stunts, og jeg ved ikke hvad, så, men han virker overhovedet ikke på nogen måde affekteret. Der er slet ikke noget af ham, og han viser tegn på, at han er verdensstjerne overhovedet ikke.
I started to skate, it's weird, my dad's a doctor, and so he wouldn't let me. And just really with my friends, I was looking at all the cool guys who were skating, and they were the surfers too. And, you know, like in the movies, the surfers are always so with the girls and stuff. So I wanted to be in there. And I started because it was popular. And it was like a big battle with my dad. He said, oh, you're never going to be any good or anything like that. So that really pushed me where I had to prove him wrong. It's a heavier, pretty hard thing to be a pro so young. And traveling, too. Traveling was strange. Like, this is something that turned me off as far as demos. I go there, and here I am, really shy kid. I really, like, from an early age, I considered it kind of a gift what I had for skating. And because I learned very quickly, and it flows for me. And I would go there, and these guys would take you in, and suddenly you're their property. Which, you know, when I was young, I didn't think about money much. You know, I mean, and here I am, all of a sudden, they're saying, hey, he's mine. And I realized by holding me and stuff, pointing me here, pointing me there, I was their property. And that's kind of weird. Yeah, it really turned me off and made me anti. That's why I can be hard as far as saying, you know, do you skate for money and do you not? Because that was really hard for me to handle.
How do you then feel about it today? You're a pro still.
Yeah. Now I don't even really think. Now I look back and I go, I get hard on other people. I think they shouldn't be pro. Like half the pros shouldn't be pro. They're not that good. They're just doing it for money. Their heart's not in it. And it's the truth, more than half. In my opinion, like 9/10. And you think, you know, what's a pro? A pro's not a big deal, right? To turn pro, all you have to do is say, I'm pro, and sign up with a company. Because companies like guys with good personalities, not really good skaters. And they make more money from them. And that's true. It doesn't matter how good the skater is usually. It's just how does he come out in cameras and things. And, yeah, being pro isn't a big thing these days. But back then, it was a little more. People took it more seriously. Back then, you had to place, like, top three in a contest to be a pro. Yeah. Beginning, there was kind of a street skating freestyle-y thing when there was nothing else, you know. So riding around on the streets, going off curbs, maybe little drainage ditches, you know. And then freestyle came out of that, a little more technical, things getting a little harder, but just on flat ground. And then the vert skating, that really hit hard. All of a sudden the parks started coming with the empty swimming pools and the ramps. And I think it's a lot more fun to watch. Some people say the vertical versus freestyle was football to ballet, you know.
Do you consider yourself as a ballet star?
Yeah, sort of a wimp. That's what freestylers are. I mean, of the freestylers, I'm supposed to be kind of the one of the strongest. And now people say, like our friend makes fun of me, oh, you're just trying to be a street skater, you know. So I'm trying to get kind of manly in my freestyle, but it's still the wimp side of things.
Isn't skating just a fad?
God, it's so hard to say. Yeah, I guess you can say in a way. Like now I'm being a hard guy against skaters. But in a way it's kind of a fad because it goes through the cyclical thing. You know, whatever, after every 5 years, whatever, 6 years. It goes through that a bit. But more than ever, I guess it's stabilized. I mean, honestly, not trying to speak up for it. It's stabilized. So sport, fad, lifestyle, whatever it is, it's getting gray area, you know, where you can call it, I don't know exactly what. It's not just a fad. Yeah.
Do you see any difference between European and American skating?
Yeah, I see a little bit of difference. Pretty much, actually. In the U.S., I guess because it's a bit older, you have these guys, the original surf style that skated pools, and they consider themselves all hardcore. That's what they use. And, yeah, they make fun of all, oh, you're just a little kid. You weren't back in the old days, you know, we used to slash pools. And I hate that attitude. It's still there. It's like, the magazines, like there's one that's really hardcore or whatever. And they just stay back in, you know, these ancient days. Which the attitudes are so wrong. That's why it gives skating a bad name. It's idiots, I think. Now it's mellowing out. Like in Europe, it's more wholesome. Like, hey, you skate? That's cool, I do too. You know, no matter how long they've been skating, they say that. And I think that's good.
When you're not skating, what are you doing then?
I'm kind of a busy life, I guess. I went to school for a while, and I'm not in school right now. I work, and I kind of have a 9-to-5 job with a lot of freedom. I own part of a skateboard company, and I do a lot of bookkeeping. I work with the team, and work with the wood shop, a couple other things, designing boards, just all around to learn as much as I can. That's what I do then. I skate after that. And tour on the weekends, and I have a girlfriend, and then spend the rest of the time, I guess, reading. And I like to read a lot, and so I think I want to finish up in school again. I mean, go back and get a higher degree, maybe PhD, Dr. Mullen.
Yeah.
I can look at myself and think, I've never worked a day in my life. That's how I feel. I make more money than my dad. It's scary.
Hey, yo, what's up?
I'm dead.
I think what?
Yeah, I'm gonna drop dead.
Yeah. So, what's going on now?
I can't even pronounce the names here. I'm not sure. I'm going somewhere tonight, and I have to take a ferry to the other side.
Let's get out of here, then.
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right.
Europacupen har dansk deltagelse i næste uge.
Det er ikke kun hiphop-glade drenges show på gader og stræder. Det er kommet ind på de bonede gulve og blevet en sport, der afholdes med såvel nationale som internationale mesterskaber. Europamesterskaberne blev afholdt for første gang i 1982, og i år var Danmark, nærmere betegnet Forum i København, vært for første gang.
Skateboard-entusiaster fra 10 forskellige lande med masser af talent og vågemod, kombineret med en 12 meter bred og 4 meter høj rampe, og rammerne er sat for et flot show og et utal af fantastiske sportspræstationer.